This should help in monitoring the provision recommended during the approval. Because once ever you get the approval, the problem is that whatever scam or illegal or irregular you are going to address, it is because lack of monitoring by the monitoring agency. They don't have manpower, they don't have sufficient time to go and individually check what are the conditions, whether these are being employed, complied or not. So if it is a cluster-wise, then I think that should be a problem for monitoring the conditions. These approvals are solely made as per approved mining plan. The fundamental thing, as you know, the approved mining plan is the Bible for all these clearances, because they declare how to develop, what is to be developed, the detailed mining method. But once you get the approval from the environmental MOEF, again you have to go to State Pollution Control Board, who doesn't have a single mining man to get their consent to operate, consent to establish. That is again a time-consuming and money-making. Public consultation concept should be dispensed to the normally termed as public nuisance concept. That is because we have just imbibed that rule from the Western countries, but we have not got the same culture with the Indian community. It is very difficult. Public consultation committee is meant for Environmental Act. But you attend any meeting, that should be a demand for my service, for my family pension, for my this thing. They are not very much concerned about the environment. High-level inter-departmental committee of state government representing mining, forest, revenue and environmental departments should consider viability of the project and render approval. Instead of public, let all these interdepartmental committee who are the core departments, let them decide about the viability of that project in that particular area. It is a wildlife management plan, as you know, for getting any forest approval. Everybody is insisting that you must get a wildlife management plan, site-specific. Whether it is 10 hectares or 1,000 hectares, you have to make. In Odisha, we have started, the department has done a regional environmental management plan in, say, covering all the iron manganese areas. And they are focused what is to be managed and how the areas, the fees will be collected from individual mines, those who are having leases in those areas. But that is not being approved by the Forest Appraisal Committee. So everybody is now trying to have a site-specific project, which is practically not possible.